Hello, and welcome to In Concert. On this week's program, we'll be featuring the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra and songstress Carrie Nimey. Each week on In Concert, it's our pleasure to present fine, outstanding local talent. And this week is no exception. The Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra, under the direction of Peter Schneider, carrying on the work of Roy C. Barnes, who was a former musician in the Sudbury area, actually in Coppercliff. He played the violin and viola. He organized a community orchestra which played throughout the North. Mr. Barnes himself was a member of the early Sudbury Symphony and founder and major of the Coppercliff Highland Cadet Corps. The orchestra library was donated by the Barnes family on Mr. Barnes' death to Peter Schneider, who formed the Memorial Orchestra that continues to carry on the good work of Roy C. Barnes. And our songstress this evening on the program, Carrie Nimey, a 17-year-old student at Sudbury Secondary in the Drama and Performing Arts Department. A lovely songstress who's going to sing for songs both old and new. And here she is now with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra to open up our program with For Sentimental Reasons.
I love you for sentimental reasons. I do hope you believe me. I'll give you my heart. I love you, and you alone were meant for me. Your loving heart to me and say we'll never part. I think of you every morning, dream of you every night. Darling, I'm never lonely whenever
love you for sentimental reasons. The Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra with the lovely songstress Carrie Nimey, who incidentally was one of the finalists in our second annual CJMX FM 105 Talent Search. Yes, Carrie can sing them all, old and new. Here she is now with Where Do Broken Hearts Go?
I know it's been some time, but there's something on my mind. But all I found was an empty place, and the only thing I learned is that I need you desperately. So here I am, and can you please tell me, where do broken hearts go? Can they find their way home, back to the open arms of a love that's waiting?
What we had was so much more than we ever had before. And no matter how I try, you're always on my mind. So here I am, and can you please tell me, oh, where do broken hearts go? Can they find their way home, back to the open arms? The love that's waiting there, and if somebody loves you,
Me with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. And for those of you who are regular listeners here to In Concert, you know that most of our programs are recorded actually before a live audience in concert. However, you don't hear any applause with this particular broadcast, and the reason is that we got the musicians together following a St. Valentine's dance for the Elizabeth Fry Society, where we had the honor and pleasure of being Master of Ceremonies. And we so enjoyed the music with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra, even though we've had them on our program before, we decided to get them into a studio, which in this case happened to be the music room at Nickel District High School. And for those of you who are technically minded, we used our Marantz professional cassette tape recorder, two PZM microphones, and a separate condenser microphone for Carrie to record this program, especially for your listening pleasure here on In Concert. So while there's no applause, you're at least on our program here, you're certainly welcome to applaud as you're listening along at home to this fine orchestra, fine talent, and of course the beautiful singing of Carrie Nyme. Right now, let's feature the orchestra themselves. 18 members of the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra under the direction of Peter Schneider. This is that old Duke Ellington favorite, Mood Indigo. the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. And as we mentioned at the opening of the program, the orchestra was formed by Peter Schneider back in 1984 in honor of Roy C. Barnes, who, as I mentioned, was a former musician in the Sudbury area, and not just a musician, but Roy C. Barnes had a dream of an orchestra that would provide light entertainment for various activities throughout the Sudbury community. This was back in the 1940s, 1950s, and he achieved that dream with his orchestra. And he put together a library, a very extensive library, which was passed on to Peter Schneider by the Barnes family when Roy died. Roy had, besides starting his own small community-based orchestra, entirely made up of volunteers, of course, he was founder and major of the Coppercliff Highland Cadet Corps and a member of the early Sudbury Symphony under Emil First. That was back in the 1950s. When Peter took over and acquired the extensive Barnes Orchestral Library, he got together, once again, volunteer players, and for the past 5 years has performed a number of concerts in the area, all volunteer concerts, and we'll talk about them later on. But first, let's return to the orchestra once again. And just a touch of Latin. Yes, cha-cha-cha with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. And now once again, our featured singer of this in-concert broadcast, together with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra, the lovely Carrie Nimey. As I mentioned, 17 years of age, has lived in the Sudbury area all of her life, actually comes from Hanmer, just north of Sudbury, and has attended St. Anne's, St. Raphael's, and Sudbury Secondary School, where she presently is concluding her education in the Performing Arts Program at Sudbury Secondary. One of the first graduates of this exciting program, Sudbury's Fame High School of the North. Carrie has been performing since, well, grade four, when she starred in The Wizard of Oz. She played Dorothy, of course. She's played in many other productions throughout the Sudbury area, and now goes on to Sheraton College in Southern Ontario, into their performing arts program, and we expect big things from Carrie in the future. Right now, here she is, and an old favorite that I'm sure all of you are going to enjoy. With the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra, here is Carrie Nimey to sing Dear Heart. Nice. Carrie Nimey, the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra, and there's still more to come after we take this short intermission. Welcome back to In Concert. I'm your host, Jack Richmond. Over the next few months, we'll be presenting a number of programs you won't want to miss. Tony Simpkin, the jazz trio and quartet, will be with us. We'll have highlights of the Northern Ontario Band Festival. The Sudbury and Sault Ste. Marie Combined Orchestral Spectacular is a program we know you'll want to catch. The Kiwanis Music Festival Final Concert. The second annual Talent Search Showcase highlights. We'll have Danny Diaz in concert, well-known local entertainer. And Gilbert and Sullivan Blueberry Festival favorites. And we'll have our Young Performers concerts as well. all coming up for you here on In Concert, each week on FM 105 CJMX. Right now, it's back to our program for this evening, the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra in Concert. The Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra has certainly been busy since it was reestablished by Peter Schneider back in 1984. They've established the series Concerts for Kids and have presented five such programs in conjunction with other area entertainers. Two Halloween haunt concerts at Science North Cavern have been held, with costumed children from the audience participating in the show. Five appearances have been made since 1984 with the Sudbury Choirs at Christmas Around the World in Christ the King Church, plus several spring concerts at the Caruso Club. Several formal concerts at the Laurentian Museum and Art Center have featured classical and popular selections with featured guest performers. And also, several piano concerto student recitals have taken place with Huntington and Marymount Conservatory students. The Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra has indeed been busy. They've done other things, too, and we'll tell you about them later in the program. But right now, it's back to our orchestra here on In Concert.
Thank you.
You're listening to In Concert and the music of the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra and their vocalist, Carrie Nimey. We asked Carrie if there was music in her family, and she said, well, sort of. Her grandmother was a singer, and her sister also sings. Carrie has studied under Daria Morley, Betty Leake, and presently Ralph McIntosh, who is head of the music department at Sudbury's Performing Arts High School, our FAME High School of the North, as I mentioned earlier. Currently into a milestone year, their first students are graduating from their program. Ralph McIntosh is the head of the music department. George Telmack and Carolyn Otto are the instructors. The drama teachers are Judy Strawn and Allison Whitty. Helen Toivonen and Arlene Lalonde are the visual arts instructors, while the dance trainers are Carol Maggio and Karen Rummel. The program is administered by Sandy Siren, and congratulations to all these people who have worked so hard over the past number of years to put this program together and who have, this year, turning out some fine graduates. And we're going to hear from one of those graduates. Here with us once again, Carrie Nimey with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra here on In Concert. Lovely Carrie Nimey with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra and September Song. We have to mention, talking about the Sudbury Secondary School and their performing arts program, mentioning its principal, Joe Dragle, the driving force behind the establishment of this exciting program. And Joe is quick to point out that Sudbury Secondary is not a performing arts school. It isn't, quoting Joe, it is a program within the regular Sudbury Secondary School curriculum, but we're the only school between Toronto and Thunder Bay to offer such a program, consisting of four art disciplines: dance, visual arts, drama, and music. Music includes voice, keyboard, winds, string, and percussion. Candidates for the program are selected on the basis of an audition from grade 8 students, of course, and once selected, the student chooses a major, studied for two semesters each year, and a minor, for one semester each year. There's been a performing arts section added to the school library with books, periodicals, and, of course, their own music library as well. It all started back in 1983 when Joe Drago got the idea for such a school. And he got on the phone to other schools which have a performing arts component, both in Canada and the United States, talked to a number of Canadian universities, and also did contact the school based on the movie Fame in New York City. A major influence was the Canterbury School of Arts in Ottawa, and in the fall of 1984, the principal of that school, John King, came to Sudbury, and his presentation to the board's administrative council was very well received. And as a result, the program was established, and as I mentioned earlier, several graduates are now coming out of the program for the very first time to go on to enter the entertainment field. Some others, of course, will just benefit from the program. They'll go into other areas of endeavor, but they'll always carry with them the memories and, of course, the magic of the performing arts program at Sudbury Secondary. Congratulations again to Joel Dragle and to the staff at Sudbury Secondary for adding so much to the entertainment life of the community and to these young people. We'll be back to our program, the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra in Concert with Carrie Nimey, right after we take this short time out. Welcome back to In Concert and the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. Probably one of the most requested dance numbers of all times. Spanish Eyes is performed by the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. 18 volunteer musicians in all under their director, Peter Schneider. I'm going to mention the musicians. Their names: on violin, John Jurdanik, Archie Canapini, and Austin Pell. Also Walter Schneider, Sally Katari, Anne Marie Jutris, and Janice Studley. On cello, John Kessick, and on bass, Dave Wells. Percussion and vocals, Forbes Studley, and on the drums, Keith Gilroy. Also on piano, Jack Flowers, and playing the trumpet, Fred Henderson and Richard Toivonen. On trombone, Vic Camiso, sax and clarinet duties, shared by Joanne Camiso and Carolyn Otto with Bill Duval. And, of course, a lovely addition to the orchestra for this in-concert, Carrie Nimey. And Carrie Nimey will be singing for us again in just a bit, but right now let's listen to the orchestra and Cherry Pink and Apple Blossom White. Once again, cha-cha-cha. Great dance music there with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. And they have been doing dances. They've performed at a number of functions, including ethnic cultural programs, senior citizens, dances and activities, the Laurentian University Museum and Arts Center, old-fashioned fairs, dinner meetings, and wedding ceremonies. And also, dancing in the old-fashioned way. Two very, very exciting programs, co-sponsored by the Elizabeth Fry Society and FM 105 CJMX. Very popular and very successful. And at these events, fundraising events for the Elizabeth Fry Society and the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra, the orchestra performed dance music of the 30s through to the 60s after a very pleasant dinner on Valentine's Day. The first was held at the Coppercliff Club, and the second at Casio's Venetia Room, because of the popularity, had to move to a larger room. My pleasure to MC both of these events, and we're looking forward, of course, to continuing throughout the years. Dancing in the old-fashioned way, in the grand style, to a delightful high-society-type dance orchestra, such as the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra becomes for these special occasions. And it was on this last occasion that we heard the lovely Carrie Nimey sing this song, most fitting for dancing in the old-fashioned way on Valentine's Day.
My funny change her hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay little Valentine, stay. Each day is Valentine's Day.
Wasn't that delightful? And when we heard Carrie Niney sing that with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra in our last dance in the old-fashioned way, we went up to her after she sang the number and said, "You have to sing that for us on an in-concert broadcast." And we got together with Peter Schneider, director of the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. We've had the pleasure of working with Peter before, and arranged for a recording date. And, well, you just heard the results. And Carrie will be back with us with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra before our in-concert program wraps up this hour. But right now, here's the orchestra, and it's polka time! With the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. We'll be back with more after this short intermission. And we're back here on In Concert. I'm your host, Jack Richmond, on the program that features outstanding local talent on a weekly basis. This week, it's the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra. In Concert. few orchids in the moonlight with the Royce Barnes Memorial Orchestra. And as we're nearing the end of our broadcast, it's time to welcome in for her final appearance, Carrie Nimey, vocalist with the Royce Barnes Memorial Orchestra for this in-concert program. Carrie, as I mentioned, will be going on to the Sheridan Community College in the Performing Arts Program. She has as her goal a career in the musical theater, and we're sure that she's going to do just fine. Recently starred in Oliver in a local Sudbury production. But here she is now with an old 1950s song done by Johnny Ray originally. Walking My Baby Back Home, the Royce E. Barnes Memorial Orchestra with Carrie Nimey. Walking My Baby Back Home there. Carrie Nimey, as I said, that one went back into, well, I guess for the first time that I remember it, at least, with Johnny Ray singing it in the early 1950s. Actually, it goes back before then. But Carrie Nimey making it come alive for us now in the late 1980s with the Royce E. Barnes Memorial Orchestra and the fine songs Old and New. And all too song, our program has to come to an end. On this In Concert, we featured the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra, 18 members strong, and vocalist Carrie Niney. Recorded, as I mentioned at the beginning, at the Nickel District Secondary School in their music room on a Sunday afternoon with our CJMX FM 105 stereo equipment. We certainly hope you enjoyed the broadcast and enjoyed the fine music, both old and new, with the Roy C. Barnes Memorial Orchestra under its director and conductor, Peter Schneider. Roy C. Barnes, a former Coppercliff resident who organized his own orchestra back in the 1940s and 50s. And now Peter Schneider making it come alive once again. And our thanks to our fine vocalist, Carrie Niney, and our best wishes for a fine career in the music theater. And, of course, our usual thanks to you, our listeners, here on In Concert. Until next time, this is Jack Richmond for Mid-Canada Radio. Thank you very much for listening.